This is the Geneva Show Report coming to you from Avant Coffee Shop in downtown Geneva. We're doing Left Jab
and Right Hook
about the politics of what's going on today. And before we start, I wanted to give you an understanding of my position. She can give me an understanding of her position. I'm not really a Democrat. I'm not really a libtard.
What are you?
I'm a part of the people. You know, when I go to Hawaii and I stay at the Moana or the Royal Hawaiian, I don't hang around with those people who stay there. I hang around with the people who wait on the people who stay there. I like the waitresses. I like the waiters. I like the bellhops. I like regular people. And so that's why I'm concerned today when I come to you. When I say something like, I'm disturbed when I hear about my own supposed people that are not providing the stimulus yet, and starting to talk about, oh, we're going to target now, which means we're going to give less money to less people. And by the way, the people who get it are going to be the people who have to get on their knees and beg for it. Well, that's disgusting to me, and I hate it. And I don't know what to say about it. I'm not right-wing. I'm not part of that Q in the on. I'm not part of the...
No, but you're a bit conservative.
Well, I don't know whether that's conservative or not. I'm about the real people out here, and I don't know how quite to describe that.
That's where a third party needs to come in. A third party that's in the middle, that's about the people, about the everyday person here in America, and putting them first and putting their needs and...
Yeah, we're doing the show right now.
It takes a phone call.
Bye.
Okay, so putting the needs of the people first. You know, caring about the people right here, right now. The ones that make the country run.
They have to
run.
Get the vaccination, and they have to get the stimulus. And that's what I'm all about. And I voted for that, and I endorsed that, and wanted to bring that in.
I think a lot of people voted for that. But I think a lot of other people didn't vote for Biden because they knew once that he was in office, that stuff was not going to be a big deal anymore. It was just to get the votes.
No, it is a big deal. It's just
it's a big deal to
us. He got handed a bad deal.
What? No.
I mean, Trump and his crew did not buy all the virus vaccinations that they said they were buying. Where is it? Where's the beef?
They paid for those vaccines over and over to get them made and get them done. In 9 months' time, vaccines were made that were never done.
If they had provided the vaccines, they would be there, but we ran out.
No, we didn't run out. The states, it's up to the states to order their vaccines. They just need to order them and get them out.
They have stopped. Vaccines that haven't even been given out in every state. And if you look at it, the UK and possibly one other country is slightly above the US in regards to how many vaccines have been administering these vaccines.
Hey, the UK has a population less than California.
No, according to population. It's according to the numbers. It's, you know how they do the mathematics.
They break it down.
That's how it's broke down. And we're in like third place. We are getting more vaccines to our people than most of the other countries. It is not a small feat. The vaccines are available.
Have you had the vaccine?
No. And
has our camera person had the vaccine?
No.
There you go.
But
it's not going to happen like that.
Yeah.
No one ever said it would. There is a lot of people in each area.
They did start vaccinating yesterday, the schools, the employees, and the people that serve the food.
The schools, really, teachers? There are some teachers on strike that will not go back to school until the children are vaccinated.
They aren't okay with just themselves being vaccinated. They shouldn't be vaccinated. There is no vaccine that's been made that is approved for a child to take yet. So really,
yeah.
Kids have to sit at home how much longer?
Because Mercy and Janesville, they were expected to do vaccines for 13 hours yesterday, and they ran out after a couple hours.
And so then I was looking back at some footage from 2016 when the presidential campaigns were were going on, and there was Biden and Trump and all the debates going on, Biden sat there out of his own mouth saying the words, executive orders are dick leadership. No one should abuse executive orders. They should be used as minimal as possible or at not at all. Or not at all. Okay, here we go. First week in office, 33 executive orders are ready. How many did Trump sign when he took office? One.
How many did Obama sign when he took office back then? Five. How many did Bush sign when he took office? Zero. Who is the dictatorship now?
Is it my turn yet?
Oh yes, I bought a roll. I'm sorry, George.
How do you cover the idiocy of what Trump created without reversing?
Which is what these executive
orders. It's my turn. They're reversing all the orders that Trump made over the years.
That people loved.
Oh yeah, they love the orders on separating kids from their families at the border. They just were in
the Really? You know there's more to that.
And what about the
money?
That
is not.
I want to go back to the stimulus. I'm only about two subjects, stimulus and vaccines. That's what are important to me. The public gets the money, not targeted money, which means less, but they get the money.
It's not going to happen under their administration.
Well, I think it will happen. I'm hopeful, too.
Because
I have nowhere else to go with that. I mean, there are a lot of people suffering out here, and they're my people. They're the waiters, they're the waitresses, they're the beach people, they're service people of all sorts, and those are my people. And I want them taken care of because I know the suffering that's going on, and they suffer silently. I mean, January 6th happened because of suffering. It was idiotic and it was stupid, and I don't think it was really an intent to take over the government. It was an intent to say, we are suffering and miserable and you've got to do something. And they got these people in $10,000 suits with their limos and their security forces and all of this that are supposedly representatives of the public, and they aren't anything like that anymore. They're morons and they're rich morons. What do you do with that? I don't know. And so here I am.
All right, well, I agree with you on all
that. Then I'm going to change my position.
Well said.
If you agree with me, it's just a rotten place to be.
Okay, come on. It's National Have Fun at Work Day.
We are having a blast.
We'll be at work in a few minutes again. We're not at work right now.
Oh, no. This is
serious.
Free for all.
Said my piece.
Okay.
This is George Belushi Jr.
Lisa Heddle.
And the Geneva Show Report.
And you are the
left.
And I'm the right.
Can I be Jen Lepkowski?
Oh, you can.